Former Republican vice presidential candidate Sarah Palin has endorsed Missouri Republican Senate candidate Sarah Steelman. Palin calls her a conservative, common sense woman. Meanwhile, Steelman is out with a new commercial attacking rival John Bruner and some of his business practices.
Commitment 2012 coverage from KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney as he takes a look at the accuracy of the ad. Michael?
It's a tough commercial. First, talking up Senate candidate Sarah Steelman.
Sarah is the only candidate who refuses to raise the debt limit so we can balance the budget.
But her rival, St. Louis Congressman Todd Akin, voted against raising the debt limit last year.
John Bruner sued for failing to pay taxes.
Actually, it was Bruner's company, Vijon. He was the CEO. In August of 2003, Vijon was delinquent on its personal property taxes. The big company owed about $1,266 with interest and penalties, and it was paid within a few weeks, the case dismissed. Late last year, a tax lien was placed on a Vijon property in St. Louis. Several weeks later, that was withdrawn when the judgment was satisfied. Now, a tax lien is a court proceeding, but it's not a lawsuit in the conventional sense.
Bruner claims to be against pork barrel spending, but his business received millions in government handouts.
Bruner sold his majority interest in Vijon in 2006. He continued on as CEO until 2009. But in 2006, he got millions for that sale, so he was facing a big state tax bill. He bought Missouri state tax credits on the secondary market, not directly from the state. And he used those tax credits to lower his state tax bill that year. Now, that's quite legal. Anybody can do it, but only the rich do.
Now, the commercial doesn't show it, but John Bruner had another tax problem. The Vijon corporate jet owed $9,200 on back taxes. Bruner says when they found out that they owed that money, they paid it. Micheal Mahoney, KMBC 9 News. Back to you.
Michael, thank you. Steelman faces Bruner and Akin in the August 7th Missouri Republican Senate primary. The winner faces Democratic incumbent Claire McCaskill in the fall.